Baltimore Ravens host the Miami Dolphins in a game that won't get a whole lot of people excited, but it's a standalone NFL Thursday night football game for week 8, and you're going to want to bet it, so let's break it down. The Ravens are 3-point favorites in the marketplace with the announcement that Jay Cutler is probably out, actually causing a little bit of Miami investment at the sportsbooks, where both sides are at minus 110. The Dolphins are a surprising 4-2 team. They'll have to play the season without a bye and had a London game thrown in the mix, but they have played well this season, at least on defense. The under is 5-1 in Miami games, and the Dolphins haven't lost against the spread since that London game, depending on what number you got last week. If you had -3, you pushed. Jay Cutler is dealing with some cracked ribs and probably won't play this week. Considering what a mess the Cutler era has been for the Dolphins, this probably is not a bad thing. Cutler was signed as a panic move when Ryan Tannehill went down with a torn ACL. Perfectly capable backup Matt Moore was passed over with the Cutler signing, and now he'll get his shot. Moore is 13 of 21 on the season with a 2-1 touchdown interception ratio. Adam Gase has spoken ill of his offense after pretty much every game this season, but things looked a lot more efficient with Moore at the helm in their 31-28 win over the Jets. That was the first time that the Dolphins had scored more than 20 points in a game. Jay Ajayi and Jarvis Landry are good building blocks at the skill positions, but the Dolphins have still struggled. The running game hasn't found the end zone yet, and the receivers have just 9.4 yards per reception. Overall, the Dolphins have managed just 4.3 yards per play. On the plus side, the defense has played well, though some regression may be coming. Miami has only allowed 112 points, but they have allowed 5.3 yards per carry, which ranks in the middle of the pack in the NFL. With only 6 takeaways and only 2 interceptions, the Dolphins look like a team in line for a reversal of fortune. Miami's defense has done a great job against the run to hold the opposition to 3.6 yards per carry and to limit big plays in the passing game with just 10.3 yards per catch allowed. Despite being a middle-of-the-pack defense overall, the Dolphins are 6th in percentage of drives ending in points at 29.3. On the other teams under 34%, only 2 have a lower turnover percentage. The Dolphins also are in the middle of the pack in sacks. The lack of big plays on defense should play a role sometime soon. The Baltimore Ravens are now 3-4 straight up and 3-4 against the spread. They have covered when they have won, and they have not covered when they have lost. The Ravens are 1-2 straight up and against the spread as a favorite this season. And interestingly, both of these teams played in London without a bye week. Since then, the Ravens are 1-3, but the Dolphins are 3-0. Just like the Dolphins, the Ravens' offense is pretty bad. In fact, the only team as bad as the Dolphins from a yards per play standpoint is the Ravens. Baltimore has 12 turnovers to Miami's 8 and has run a lot more plays with a similar success rate. Joe Flacco still doesn't look right with just 152 passing yards per game and a 5-8 touchdown interception ratio. Maybe the Ravens have found something recently, though, with the legs of Alex Collins, who has averaged 5.9 yards per carry. But the Ravens are struggling to create opportunities. Jeremy Maclin hasn't gotten free for big plays, and Flacco can't really throw deep anyway. The loss of Danny Woodhead has been a huge problem as well. The Ravens only have 13 plays of 20 or more yards, so they certainly aren't making things easy on themselves when it comes to scoring points. This is another case where regression could be coming from the defense. Baltimore's defense is living off of 15 takeaways with 5.1 yards per play allowed, which is a little bit better than average. The Ravens had 10 takeaways combined in the first 2 games and won both of those games. With 5 takeaways in 5 games since, their record is 1-4. The Ravens are also flirting with disaster in the secondary. Baltimore has only allowed a 55.2% completion rate against, but has allowed 12.2 yards per reception when the passes have been completed, including 17 plays of 20 or more yards. This past week, Minnesota ran the ball as effectively as any team has with 5.1 yards per carry. That may be a sign of the pressure on this defense and how much it limits the margin for error. See if a 3.5 pops up for this game if you didn't get a chance to grab it earlier. The Miami Dolphins are probably better off with Matt Moore running the offense, and he probably should have been in charge all along. At the very least, he can't be any worse than Jay Cutler. The Ravens have now allowed 166, 173, 108, 231 and 169 rushing yards over the last five games, so Moore may not even have to throw the ball a lot. It is a bad spot for both teams and a particularly tough travel spot for the Dolphins, but the Dolphins are playing better football than the Ravens right now, and the players can look forward to a weekend off with a good effort in this game. Our pick and prediction is for the Miami Dolphins at +3. For our pick and prediction on this game and every other game this week, and a wealth of free stats and information, check out bangthebook.com